greetings. This has become part 3, or C, in my response about Isaiah 42:12. Let's move on to the next section of the Muslim response. Yehovah means He who is self-existing, self-sufficient. Sorry, brother. Nothing a Muslim claims can ever be accepted as true. Produce proof. References, lexicons, Hebrew dictionaries that derive and prove this meaning. When Yehovah is talking to Moses, God says to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you. That is the description, not a definition of the meaning of Yehovah. It is a deceptive Islamic tactic to define words conveniently to fit the Islamic narrative. Didat perfected this deceptive approach. Does Allah have this title too? Surely yes, it is the greatest of the 99 names of Allah. Al-Hayul Kayam. I mispronounced that, I'm sure. Bless your heart, I know someone named Buddy. I also know someone who named their cat Buddy. The first person is not the cat, just because they have the same name. Muslims love to name their sons Muhammad, but that does not make them the reincarnation of Muhammad. Likewise with same descriptions. Lew Alcindor was a very tall man. So was Dirk Nowitzki, a very tall man. Just because they share a description, very tall man, does not mean they are the same man. When the one true God, Yehovah, declares he is the creator, he is telling the truth. Any pretender to the throne, Zeus, Thor, Beelzebub, Satan, Allah, can claim they are the creator, but that does not make it true. Second, when Yehovah God demonstrates his power over and over, he proves his power. This fake pretender Allah never did one single visible miracle of any kind. Claims, Allah really did those other miracles when people were saying Yehovah, is a lie for naive fools. Isaiah 42:8, I am Yehovah, that is my name. I will not share my glory with another, or my praise to idols. Yehovah God does not share his glory with this Allah pretender. But it is a clever element of Satan's deception to pick a language, Arabic, that has a word meaning the God. Al-Hayu Kayum has the same meaning. So in this point you clearly lost. Yehovah is Allah. Not even close, Son Erdogan. Similar meaning is neither evidence nor proof. And the 99 superlatives Muhammad's Quran ascribes are just that. Descriptions, many of which are human comparisons. But let's focus on your argument one more time. Yehovah God means self-sufficient one, according to you. Allah has one of 99 names that means self-sufficient one. Therefore, Yehovah is Allah, again, according to you and your argument. But your argument creates a damning problem for Islam. Allah has one of 99 names that is Al-Haq, meaning the truth. Jesus, Yeshua, the Son of Man and Son of God, said he was the truth. Therefore, Jesus is your Allah. Again, according to you and your argument. Can you begin to see the weakness, the error of your argument? A similar description means nothing to prove identicality. An unsupported claim of a similar description means even less than nothing. By the way, Allah means the only true God. Who is the only true God in your book? We'll overlook for a moment Allah actually means nothing more than the God without your deceptive embellishment. The one true living God is Yehovah, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Ancient of Days. and we have already decimated the name meaning something like nonsense. You can bet followers of every false deity all think their deity is the only true God. Case in point, Allah, a false pretender, claiming to be the only true God, Jehovah. It is the God of Jesus who is only one person, John 17:3, so don't try to fool people. Stay on topic. Bless your heart. Context matters. Let's look at the context of this verse, you attempt to rape, brother. But let's look at that in the next video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.